All right, my name is Dave Ratt, and this is the second part of a three-part series of videos I'm doing where we're actually listening to the loss of sound in speaker cables. In part one, if you haven't watched that yet, I described the setup in its entirety, how it's wired, and go into some detail on that. Basically, what we're doing is hooking a speaker and an analyzer across one of the wires of the test speaker cable such that the speaker is outputting the sound, the difference in sound between what is sent into the cable and what's coming out. So we're listening to the difference between the two ends. You'll also hear the end of the cable too. I'll do some comparisons. In this video, I'll be demonstrating the difference between a 100 foot 12 gauge pro audio cable versus a 50 foot 16 gauge install grade cable. So you got a thinner, shorter cable versus a longer, thicker wire, and we can listen to the tonal differences of the loss between those two. Additionally, we'll do coiled versus uncoiled, where I'll leave them spooled up and I'll uncoil them, and you can actually hear the difference in sound caused by coiling a cable or leaving it coiled, or the different types of cables. Then I'll go on to do a 50 foot 12 gauge cable, pro audio cable, versus a THHN electrical grade stranded cable that you would wire your house with or use in electrical boxes. And that's coiled, really tightly coiled, so you can really hear an extreme version of what a coiled cable sounds like. And finally, I'll do those two coiled cables versus a twisted pair of THHN, the exact same wire, but twisted into a pair. And I'll coil that up into a coil and uncoil it. And maybe find these results interesting, and I hope you enjoy, and part three will come soon. All right, so for our next phase of testing, what I'm going to do is take off this 12 gauge, 25 foot cable and leave the 100 foot 12 gauge cable there, and we're going to bring in this 16 gauge 50 foot cable. So this is a shorter cable, it's half the length, and it's a thinner gauge, and let's listen to the difference between the two. First, we'll start with our coiled 100 foot cable. As we can see, there's the 6.3K peak rolling off quite a bit down at 20K. And I'll switch to the 16 gauge. And I won't switch to the 16 gauge. That's what happens if I hook it up wrong, because I was hooked up to pin. I had this banana plug reversed. So let's try that again. 16 gauge, 12 gauge 100 foot. 16 gauge 50. And 16 gauge sounds a little brighter, a little more clarity on the top end. They're relatively the same in volume, even though this one's twice the length. The thicker wire gauge is made up for the, even though it's a longer length, but the thicker wire gauge is made up for the thinner wire gauge, shorter length. The frequency response is different though. So let's go ahead and uncoil this 16 gauge. And compare a more real-world situation. Let's do what we're listening to it. There's a 16-gauge uncoiled. We can see it's fairly flat. There's a slight boost in the high end. The boost in the high end, remember this is the loss, which means it's losing some high end. We're only looking at what's being dissipated by the cable. And we go to the coiled 100-foot. And we can see that the uncoiled 16 is flatter and sounds better than the coiled 100 foot. Let's go ahead and uncoil the 100 foot because we don't like the way the coiled 100 foot sounds or looks. And sorry about banging that mic there. I'm going to spool it over here. Cable messes here, give me some practice winding stuff up a little bit later. And now we have an uncoiled 100 foot and an uncoiled 16 foot comparison, 50 foot 16 gauge. That's interesting because we can hear, that's the 100 foot, 50 foot 16 gauge, 12 gauge 100 foot. 12 gauge 100 foot is clearly brighter than the 16 gauge, which is duller, which means that the 16 gauge has less high frequency loss at 50 feet than the 12 gauge does at 100 feet. All right, let's keep going. I'll put that over there. Turn that down and let's grab another cable. Let's get into our 50 foot here. This is a 50 foot. I'm gonna take out the 100 footer. We're done with that. And we're gonna stick with 50 footers from here on out. And this is coiled. Here, now we will listen to the 50 foot 12 gauge. And that's coiled. Again, we see the inductive peak. And if it's a lower, if the amp up all the way, this is the lower volume than the 100 foot, which is to be expected. Now, what I'm going to do is grab. Let's go to worst case scenario. This is AC wire that you would use to wire your house, THHN wire, and it's in two coils. I just basically cut the spools off and left them fairly coiled up. I'm going to plug this banana in correctly this time and plug this in, and we'll listen to the coil THHN 50 foot versus a Pro Audio type cable in its coil with the pairs coiled together. And as you can hear that, here there, the THHN is extremely loud, and that's for the same reason. These are forming extremely effective inductors. In fact, they're so effective that we can show that too. Here's a half inch socket. That on, and we'll be able to tell which one it is. And all I'm doing is inserting a steel socket extension into the coil, forming an iron core, which improves the increases the inductance, which makes it roll off even more. And we see that we've got a lot of high frequency roll off when I do that. This one doesn't do anything, I'm not measuring that. But if I go to that other coil here, it does the same thing. Alright, so that is a good demonstration of the extremes of coiled wire, THHN versus Pro Audio cable. So you may be asking yourself, well, THHN versus Pro Audio cable, maybe it's the sound of the THHN and the coils. Let's go ahead and check that out too. So what I'm going to do now is get rid of this 50-foot Pro Audio cable. And this is actually an NL2 cable, which is why, if you notice, it's a little thinner than the NL4 cable that I was using before. Let's go ahead and grab what I did here. When I took THHN cable, I unspooled it, got a drill out, and spun it into a twisted pair. I'm going to get that somewhat coiled up. And we're going to go ahead and listen to that. Plug that in. Plug this in. And this will be... This is exactly the same type of cable. I've got a green and a black THHN and two whites. The color shouldn't make much difference. But let's go ahead and listen to the coiled cable versus the twisted cable that's coiled into a loop-ish. And that's really quiet. Probably because this is not attached. There it is. Okay. Sorry about that. Let's go ahead. I took all the shells off these end, of course. There we go. So there's the twisted THHN and the coiled THHN. So twisting the pairs is extremely important for maintaining high frequency response and making it more impervious to being coiled. Now we can take this. It's going to cut out because of these. We can take this and unspool it onto the floor into my cable mess. And see that it doesn't make too much a difference. And back to me. All right.